Yes. So Ben gets here to the box and just sit down. All right. So I wanted to give a couple of introductions before we continue on. Also give them a little bit of a break before we plug away with our halftime show. First of all, I would like to introduce you to our director of bands and my partner in crime here in the band world at Temple University, Dr. Trish Cornett.
As Dr. Brunner said earlier, this is a great day. It's one of my favorite days of the year when sort of school officially gets going. And as Dr. Brunner said, I'm to the director of bands here, so I oversee all the bands here at Temple, but by far one of my favorite parts of my job is hanging out with the Diamond Marching Band every fall. They are some of my favorite people. They are fun and funny and quirky in all the best ways, super smart, and by far some of the hardest working students here on campus. And it is just a joy to spend time. Yes, you can clap for that, of course. And it is just such a joy to spend time with them every fall and watch how hard they work and how proud they make Temple University at everything that they do. So I'm so glad to welcome you all here today, welcome you all to this new season and all the great things that are about to lie ahead. So thank you for being here, and I'll throw it back to Matt. Go Owls!
Thank you. I'd also like to say hi to a couple of our administrators that are here. Dean Robert Stroker. Vice Dean David Brown. If there's more, sorry, I haven't seen you. I'll catch you later. I'd also like to introduce to you our graduate assistants, our teaching assistants, who have, you know, just been doing a lot of work, especially the last couple weeks, and really throughout the week have been a humongous help with everything. First of all, our returning TA, Emily Pohl. And our first year TA, Kalia Page. This year we were also fortunate enough to be able to hire full-time drumline and color guard instructors. They've been doing an amazing job already. First, our color guard instructor, Emily Malovsky. And our drumline instructor, Paul Nalesnik. David Payne also already introduced them, but our drum majors, Noah Barr, Jeremy Shamai, and Sam McFarland. Even with all of that help right there, this does not function without student leadership in every section, in many different facets of what they do. Some are using some of their talents that they are getting in their major field, and some are just talented in a field that we need help in, and they can do it. Could I have all of the student leadership stand up? I want to also give a special welcome to any alumni that are here, any alumni band members that are here. And a special welcome to any first year students, new members, parents, where are you? Have a really good time this year. I know the students will. So I have been waiting for this day for months, literally. Every year, our first show is often the hits of the summer. And, you know, it's been a couple years since we've had some really good music to use. So I was really excited to write this show and to get to it. It was also hard to pick something. Because there was so much good stuff that was out there, I finally settled on something, and we're going to show it to you today. So, all the arrangements are done by myself, and percussion arrangements are done by Paul Malesnik, and here's our first show, Songs of the Summer.
Summer 2024. Let's order another round
of shaloozie as we get a little
tipsy
Thank you.
Ben. Have a seat, please. So, everyone, got one more thing for you. I've kind of been waiting 5 months for this. You know, I've been here for 17 years now, and this year ties me with Professor Arthur Chodorov for the longest marching band director that has been here. And it's a special year because this is the 99th year. The 99th year of the band. And the 99th year of the band. And next year is our 100th anniversary. And it is, we're hoping that it's going to be a really, you know, a really big deal. And I know, the Annie Malmet 100th anniversary gala is in its planning stages right now. So hopefully we can look forward to that. But we hope to see, you know, a lot of alumni come back every year, not just this year or next year, but all the time. Because this band doesn't get to where it is and gets to do the things that it does without the people that came before. And so the alumni that have, you know, gone through, whether it's hard times, good times, whatever, they all put a piece of their personality into this band. And that was extremely important. And for everybody that's in the band, the seniors that are in the band, seniors, raise your hand. The seniors that are in the band, they have put their personality and they've put a mark on this band. As I hope that, you know, everybody that has come through here. I had to thank all of the people that have come through all of this, you know, even from my first year, the Tina DeMeglios, the Jeff Molishes, the Phil Wisecheck, the Joanne Mallow, the, you know, Max Torrenti, all these alums that, you know, the first year that I was here, they could have said, the heck with this guy. We don't like what he's doing, so we're not going to listen. But they bought into it. And, you know, the band has gotten to do a lot since then because of the effort, because of the excellence, because of the quality, because of, you know, just the energy. That's the thing about this group, that, you know, we're not as big as some bands out there. We don't have the, you know, the Big Ten or SEC budgets that are out there that some of these bands have, but, you know, we just can do whatever it is that we do. So we're hoping that next year this is a moment, this is a time that will, you know, really celebrate the longevity and the accomplishments of what this band has done. And I know it is going to be an absolutely incredible year. What I wanted to reveal to you today is that we have a logo that we are sharing, that we're going to use next year as part of our season, part of what we're, you know, what's going to happen. We're going to use it for a couple of performances, and we hope that it's something that is meaningful to everybody. I'm sure a lot of you will recognize bits of it, but this is something that represents all of the hard work, all of the dedication, not just the students in the band, but all of the students that have ever been through this band, and everyone that has ever supported this band. Can I show you this?
Yeah.
Madeline Dingman, Ollie Gomez, and Harry Sirianni for their input into this event. This is something that is, you know, kind of a bucket list thing that everyone hopes that they get to do. So for the first time ever, Temple University Diamond Band will be performing in New York City. In the 2025 Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. Let me invite Dean Robert Stroker to give a couple comments.
We're going to New York. New York. This has been the most difficult couple months, keeping this secret until this very moment. You have no idea. I've been in so many meetings, visiting with alums, and I'll begin to say, oh, I got news for you. Oh, sorry, I can't say that. But we are here today, and I just want to congratulate all of these amazing students, musicians here at Temple University for this accomplishment. This is a major, major accomplishment. I believe there was 179 bands that applied for two spots, and you're one of them. Special welcome today, and thank you to all the parents, families, and loved ones. This just doesn't happen that they just picked up an instrument on Wednesday and started playing. This is years and years of support, lessons, rehearsals, concerts. We owe you so much. Thank you to all the family, friends, and loved ones of our students. Last thing I'm going to say is, as Matt was saying, next year is the 100th anniversary of the Diamond Band, and what an honor to be able to share the spirit and pride of Temple University with millions and millions of viewers around the world at the Macy's Day Thanksgiving Parade. It's such an honor, and we're so grateful to the good folks at Macy's for making this possible. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. Now I would like to introduce you to Charlie Bibbo, who is from the Center, who is the manager of the Center City Macy's.
Congratulations.
congratulations for being selected to march in the 99th production of the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. You deserve it. Woo!
Anyway, oh yeah, I've been holding on to that for like 5 months. And it's been so hard with some of you. Some of you seniors wonder when I would say, you sure you're not coming back for a fifth year? How my logistics, this year I was a little behind on things, had other stuff going on. So, now you know. So yeah, we're very excited about this. To go on for next year, but this is next year. We have this year to do. First thing I think we want to get a shot of is bring the check and the drum head in front of the band, and everyone should have some confetti poppers there. So listen, there's a cap on it. Take the cap off. Flick it up. Up. We're all going to do it together on the count of three. Where's Charlie? Let's have Harry, Madeline, Ollie. Harry, Madeline, and Ollie are probably the only students that knew that I was doing this. Because they put together the video that was sent in, all of the videos that were sent in, and it was quite an ordeal. My wife can attest to the fact that uploading everything was a little bit of an ordeal. So guys, you guys can hold the money. Everybody grab a handful and stick it in your pocket. All right. Thank you very much, everyone. Thank you, everyone.